Hey, good morning. It's Friday. We're in the middle of having conversation about having conversations. Just talking about how we can do this and do this in a way that pours life, pours value into other human beings. Why is it so tough? Why is it so hard to have good, meaningful conversations? Well, the answer is obvious. It's people. People are involved in conversations, right? And people believe completely opposite things. You know, it's kind of like this crazy situation where someone's saying what they believe, and like we either don't believe what they believe, and we go quiet and we clam up and then tell everybody else what we really think, or we shoot our mouth off and drive people away. So how can we actually do conversations well with people that we don't agree with? Well, we're into it. A couple of fruit of the spirit deep. And the first one was love. And it's just a general affection for others. Just liking people, choosing to like people, even though they're they don't seem to have all the marbles together. We can actually still choose to have affection for one another. The second is an exuberance about life. This is just like a general undercurrent of joy. We just like choosing not to be sour, not to be a victim all the time, just choosing joy. Exuberance about life. And the next on the list would be serenity. Peace is the way that the old translations used to render it. Serenity is the way that Eugene Peterson talks about it in The Message. Serenity. It makes me think about the serenity prayer. Serenity prayer. Something that the Alcoholics Anonymous people have kind of scooped up and used to great effect, right? Lord, grant me the serenity to accept the things I cannot change, the courage to change the things I can, and the wisdom to know the difference. That's good. That's a good prayer. I mean, addicts know, right? Maybe better than anybody, but addicts know that it's just impossible to try to change someone, right? And they just know the frustration and want to throw their hands in the air and say, it's not going to work. It's never going to work. We might as well just keep doing what we're doing. And that's not the solution, right? The solution is not to toss people off. That isn't it. But they do know the futility of trying to change somebody before they're ready to change because, well, they were there themselves at one point, really sure that they knew exactly what was going on in their life and this is the way the world is. And then, by the kindness of God, things shifted. One of the beauty things about going to an AA meeting is that they don't try to fix each other. Right? They don't preach at each other. What they've learned to do is just say their piece and then sit back in their chair. There's no kind of like fixing. They have this rule about crosstalk. No crosstalk. Don't be trying to take someone else's comments out, take them out by the knees. None of that stuff. Say your piece as honestly as you know how before God and the room that you're in. And then you leave the rest of it in bigger hands. That's a good picture of serenity. Let's just leave the rest of this in bigger hands. I think it's actually a really key piece to having a good conversation or having healthy relationships. Make space for God. Now, the stunning thing for me is that Jesus rolls like this. Like, Jesus is the one person who should fix people. Jesus, jump in there, fix that action, right? Jesus is the one person who should tell people how it's going to be. But he allows people to make up their own mind. He gives them space. There's a verse in the Bible where Jesus is actually saying, "Behold, I stand at the door and knock. If anyone hears my voice and opens the door, then I will come in with her or with him, and I'll eat with them." It's this beautiful picture of an offer of intimacy. But get the picture, like it's knocking. What? That's the Lord of all glory who knocks, waiting. Are you serious? The God of the galaxies. Waits, are you nuts? Right? I wonder if, this is what happens when you knock. I wonder if someone is going to answer. This is the God of the universe. Wait a second. Anyone? Bueller? Right? If I was God, I'd be jumping up on people's shoulders and biting their heads off and barking down their throats and telling them, listen, you get yourself on side here or it's going to go to fire and brimstone real fast. But not Jesus. Knocks. And waits. He's the Prince of Peace. He's the Prince of Serenity. That's a great picture of serenity for us. Like, I can't change you. Almost end of story. I can't change you. I am interested in what you have to say. And if you're interested in what I have to say, then I'm willing to share that with you. But if you're not interested in what I have to say, that's fine. You know, I can wait. Serenity means accepting those things that I can't change. And it means changing those things by God's grace that I can change. And in the middle of this, respecting your freedom to think and choose differently than I do. It's a great place, actually. And then one day Jesus will come and make it all right and clear. I had a professor in university, and he's scribbling away on his board. We're talking about the problems with this thinker and that thinker and this thing, the church that's going on there. And then he turns around and he says, "We all have flat sides. Not one of us gets it 100% clear." And he goes back to writing on the board and then turns a couple minutes later and says, "And oh yeah, I've got them too. And you just got to figure out what my flat sides are." You know, that's a plan for a community built on peace, giving respect to each other, freedom to choose, believing as we do as Christians, a day is coming when Jesus will make it all right. And then we will finally, each of us, see where we were wrong, where we were right, and Jesus will make the whole thing right. Okay, thanks be to God. Go in the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, love of God the Father, and the friendship of the Holy Spirit this Friday. Amen.